solar cell, which is also known as a photovoltaic cell, converts solar energy, that is light energy, directly into electrical energy. The diagram shows the construction of a solar cell. In its simplest form, it uses n-type semiconductor substrate. A trivalent impurity is diffused on its top surface such that a thin p-type layer is formed. Metallic contacts are formed on both the layers for external circuit connections. Top surface is coated with anti-reflecting material to increase absorption of light energy. Finally, it is covered with thin protecting glass. In a simplest form, we can say that it uses n-type semiconductor substrate. On its top surface, a thin p-type layer is formed. While junction is forming, depletion layer and potential barrier builds up because of crossing of majority carriers across the junction. When photons of energy greater than the band gap, that is h nu is greater than eg, are incident on the cell, the photons are absorbed and electron hole pairs are generated. The barrier potential segregates them and pushes electrons to N side and holes to P side. This displacement of charges sets up a potential voltage across two regions, with P side as positive and N side as negative electrode. If external load RL is connected, the current flows through it and we get electrical energy. The separation of carriers is possible due to the intrinsic electric field of the depletion region. The diagram shows when the light generated electron in the p-type region reaches the p-n junction, it is swept across the junction by the electric field at the junction. It reaches n-type region where it is now a majority carrier. Similarly, the light generated hole reaches the p-type region and becomes a majority carrier in it. The positive and negative charges are thus accumulated on the P region and the N region of the solar cell, which can be used as a voltage source. When the solar cell is connected to an external circuit, the light generated carriers flow through the external circuit. The intersection of the curve with the I-axis is the short circuit current, that is ISC, corresponding to a given light intensity. The intersection of the curve with the V-axis is the open circuit voltage, that is VOC, corresponding to given light intensity. Again, power delivered to the load is zero when the load is open. However, there is a point on the curve where power delivered is maximum, and that point is obtained as PL, which can be given as VOL.ISC.